Hello guys, and welcome back to another Scriptcase tutorial. Fred here speaking, and today I'm gonna talk about Google Fonts. So first, what is Google Fonts? Maybe you know Google Fonts as Google Web Fonts. Actually, right now it's just Google Fonts. So basically, it's a huge library containing more than 900 different free types of fonts. And you can actually browse all these fonts just going to fonts.google.com and see the entire list. So during this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to import one font, for example, or more than one, and import into our Scriptcase theme, and how to apply it to our buttons as well, and how it will look into our Scriptcase application. All right, so first, we need to know the name of the font that we want in our application. So you just need to scroll down here or just use this search for look at your font. All right, so in my case, I will use this one, call it Oswald. So you just need to click here in the red button here. And you will see here that you have one family font selected. You don't need a Google account for use these Google fonts, so you just need this URL right here. So I'll copy it. And right now we can go to our Scriptcase, and we can go to the CSS application themes. So it's located here in layout, CSS application themes. And from here you can see all the different themes of Scriptcase, and you can save as with another name. In this case, I already done that. So we have here this Sweet Amour 2, and just need to go to advanced mode. And in this box right here, we can paste the URL from Google Fonts. And we can change all the fonts of the theme. So I will go for this option. And right now we can insert the name of the font that we want to use. In this case, it's Oswald. And it's recommendable here to add another alternative standard font. In this case, could be sans serif or Arial. Okay, and you can also apply these fonts to your button set. So I'll select another button set, and I will apply these Google font changes to my theme and to my button set. All right, so let's save here. And right now we can apply this new theme to my application. In this case, it's a grid. So we can go here to layout here and settings. Okay, and we can choose one theme for my entire application and another theme for my button set. If you leave this field as blank, you will use the button set of your theme. All right, so in this case I will just use this as default. All right, and I will run my application to see how it looks like. So here we have the final result of this Google Fonts. Looks really nice, really different from the standard Scriptcase applications. So what if your final system has no internet connection? Well, actually, the Google font won't work, and it will use the default font that you selected during the applying step, all right? But we also offer an option for offline users, all right? So you can just go here again to CSS application themes, And we do have this Google Font offline option. So we can select yes here, and we can also download the font. Just clicking here in this download button. So you have to wait a few seconds. And finally, the download is complete. So right now you're using Google Fonts offline, and once you deploy your project, even if you don't have internet connection, your application will be working as usual. All right. So that's a good news. We can use Google Fonts online or offline. All right. So remember first to download the font. Okay. So the final step of this tutorial will be how to apply more than one font at the same time. So again, let's go to Google Fonts, and we have here the selection. All right, I was working with this one, so I'll go for let me check another one. This one. Okay, we have here five fonts families selected. So we can again copy the URL. Okay. And going back again to our script case, and we just need to paste the entire address. So let's save this theme. So in this case, I'm gonna use it offline as well. So just click here in the download button. Okay, the download is complete. So I will try to apply this, all these fonts. And the primary font in this case will be Ubuntu. And Arial as the second one. Okay, here, save. Now let's go to our application. Again here, the same theme, all right? And I will run this application. Let's see if it changed. So yes, I'm using here the Ubuntu font, okay. Is this one right here. So that's all for today. I hope you'll can apply Google Fonts into your Scriptcase projects. And if you liked this tutorial, please give me a thumbs up. And thanks for watching.